In this illustration, we'll study about battery reversal in a capacitor. Here it says that a battery of 40 volt is connected to a 5 microfarad capacitor. And after a steady state is reached, battery is disconnected and reconnected to the capacitor with reverse polarity. And we are required to find the amount of heat produced after reconnection of battery. Let's solve the situation. Here, if we draw the picture, we are given that there is a 5 microfarad capacitor which is connected to a 40 volt battery along with a switch which is, say, closed, and a steady state is reached. Now, in this situation, we can write, in a steady state, initial charge on capacitor is, this Q initial we can write as CV, that is 5 multiplied by 40, this will be 200 microcoulomb. Obviously, on the side where potential is high, it will be positive polarity, and on the other side, it is negative polarity. Now, we disconnect the battery and we connect it with reverse polarity to the same capacitor. The battery is also same. So, in this situation, in final state, again we can see the charge on capacitor will be CV, but this will be positive and this will be negative. So, we can write, as potential difference is same, final charge on capacitor will be same, but with opposite polarity. This implies, if we calculate the total charge flown through battery after reconnection, is, this can be written as delta Q. As earlier it was plus 200 microcoulomb, finally it will become minus 200 microcoulomb. So, the charge which will flow through this battery will be 400 microcoulomb. And in this situation, if we calculate the heat produced in circuit after reconnection, this can be given as H, which is delta Q whole square by 2C, the direct relation we already studied in the concept videos. So, here on substituting this 400 whole square by 2 into 5. So, this will be 16,000 microjoule, or it is 16 millijoule. That will be the answer for this situation. We can also calculate this heat produced by calculation of work done by battery minus energy absorbed by capacitor. In this situation, as no energy is absorbed by the capacitor because its initial and final charge remain same. So, work done by battery can be calculated by the charge flown through battery multiplied by the potential difference, which is delta Q flow multiplied by battery EMF. So, here it can be given as 400 microcoulomb multiplied by 40. So, this is also 16,000 microjoule, that is 16 millijoule. So, either ways you can get it. This is a direct way to calculate the amount of heat produced, and this is the traditional way in which already we have studied in concept videos.